So the next topic which we are going to discuss is measurement of atmospheric pressure. You are well known that when we have fever, we have one device that is known as thermometer with which we can calculate the amount of fever which we are having. If we want to calculate the mass of an object, we have beam balance. If we want to calculate the weight of the object, we have spring balance. If we want to measure the liquid, it is in liters form, we have the liter to calculate the quantity or volume of the liquid. Hence, we have the different devices to do the work. So now, if we have atmospheric pressure around us, we want to measure the quantity of the atmospheric pressure. So we need one device or we need one instrument which is being used to measure the atmospheric pressure. So the atmospheric pressure is being used, atmospheric pressure is measured with the help of one device or instrument which is known as barometer. What is barometer? Barometer is an instrument which is used to measure the atmospheric pressure. So here we are having three type of barometers. Firstly, atmospheric pressure, we want to measure, we need one device. That device is known as barometer, or you can say in definition form, instrument used to measure atmospheric pressure is known as barometer. There are three type of barometers we are having. Number one is simple barometer, number two, Fortin barometer, number three, Henroid barometer. So firstly, we will discuss about the simple barometer. I will show you the diagram. Diagram is, it's a simple trough. Inside this simple trough, we have placed one tube upside down. The thing is, this leak trough having mercury inside it. This liquid is mercury, and the main thing is, this tube must have vacuum inside. If it is not having vacuum, this mercury is not going to rise in upward direction. So, simple trough, in simple trough, we fill this trough with, mercury and place this vacuum tube inside the mercury so that the mercury will rise upward. If mercury is going to rise, it rises up to some level which show the atmospheric pressure. If it rises up to point A from O, OA is the total height up to which the pressure, mercury rises. So the pressure exerted by the atmosphere is OA, or you can say till point A. So here are some of the drawbacks of this. Firstly, I will tell you why we use mercury. Afterwards, we will discuss about the drawbacks. Why we use mercury? First point of mercury is it's opaque. Opaque means iske aar paar nazar nahi aata. So if it is opaque, we are very familiar that opaque object can be visible very clearly. So mercury can show its level easily over here. Second, if it is opaque, secondly, it does not stick to the walls. Ye walls ko touch karegi, par ye walls ke saath chipkegi nahi. Don't stick to walls. It means if we use instead of this, if we use water. First point is also the drawback of water, that it is not opaque, it is transparent and we are unable to measure the proper level clearly. Second, don't stick to the wall is the benefit of mercury. But water, if we put water somewhere, water droplets are there. Afterwards, when they attach, the level changes. Afterwards, again some or more liquid is going to attach with the lower level. Again, the level rises up. So, if it sticks, it changes the level. But the proper or the advantage of mercury being used in the liquid as a liquid in this barometer is it is not going to stick the wall of the tube. If it is not stick, it means it is not going to come afterwards and add in the liquid downward, and hence the level is going not to be changed. So the drawbacks which we are going to consider now, firstly, This trough is of a simple barometer is open. So dust particle can enter from here and the density of the mercury varies. Secondly, no support to tube. This tube is approximately of 1 meter long tube. This length of the tube is 1 meter. If it is 1 meter long, it needs some support to be handled. Otherwise, it fall down and our simple barometer is being damaged. So the thing is, tube is not having any support. Third is, we don't have any scale for measurement. यहाँ पे आसपास कोई scale नहीं है जिससे measure कर सके. So due to this structure, we are unable to carry this simple barometer from one place to another place. So if it is unable to be portable, we are unable to carry from one place to another. So these are the drawbacks. Due to these drawbacks, simple barometer is changed to new form, that is 14 barometer. Whatever the demerits of this simple barometer that are changed as a merits in 14 barometer, and we use this 14 barometer very clearly. I will show you the diagram from the book itself. See this diagram. You are able to see the trough. I will compare the diagram. See this diagram. This is open trough. If it is open, no tube support is there, no scale is there, hence we can't use it easily. We can't take it from one place to another. So now you can see in this diagram, firstly the brass case is there. If brass case is there, it means the tube support is there. Tube support is there, similarly tube, after having tube support, you can see this glass vessel in which the leather cup is there. It is also covered with the help of brass case. So this trough is also covered now. No chances of adding impurity in this mercury, and the density is going to be vary. So it's very easy for us to measure. Secondly, one scale. You are able to see these lines also. This indicate the scale which is inside the brass case or marked on the brass case, so that you can measure the level of mercury very clearly. This mercury now showing in black color, but when you are having it, it is of silver color and it's very shining. You can able to see it in, you don't have barometers at home, but you have the thermometer at your homes. So you can see the bulb of the thermometer at your home, that is also a shining surface, and you are able to measure your temperature through the capillary rise of mercury. So same way, the rise of mercury level in this tube is there. So 14 barometer are having benefits as comparative to simple barometer. If you read it, it makes you more clarity. So need to read the chapter.